I already made sure that I put my foot down on things. And I, you know, I don't want to like get into all this discussion about, you know, these personal relationships and all this stuff. I just told Matt, I said, look, I don't know what you're going to do. I don't know what the free agency situation is. And hopefully you'll end up figuring that out. But I forbid you. I absolutely.
You're forbidding Matt Martin something?
Yes, forbid you to even think, even remotely think about going to the Philadelphia Flyers.
What if they offer more than anybody else?
I don't give a rat's ass.
Oh, you should. Sidney should.
That is over.
What you're telling me that if the Philadelphia Flyers came in with the longest and most lucrative contract out of anybody in the league, that you would, then you have to cover the difference. That should be the deal.
That's fair.
Time out. I've already covered the difference. It was called the wedding. It's called, you know, making sure everybody's happy, everybody's good, everybody's fine. I already did that. I'm just saying that is it. That breaks everything.
But G brings up a great point. Flyers offer him $3.5 million a year. His next best offer is $2.1 million.
I don't give a crap. There's just certain things I cannot deal with.
Well, he might do it, and he might burn a bridge with you, but he'll be set up in the future a hell of a lot better.
I mean, he's too classy a guy to put that stupid jersey on. And, you know, and I know that he plays a very physical style, and I'm sure, like, you know, the Flyer fan would love that. But, you know, too bad. That is off the table. I've already put my foot down on that one.
If that actually happens and you make him turn it down, you better groom him to be Martin and Gio when you're set to retire, because he's going to still have to make money.
Right, exactly.
Hey, Jerry, I'm all about the work. I'm all about making the money. I'm all about showing up and working hard. But then there are certain things like you just say no to. There's just no way.
What if it was his only offer?
It isn't.
No. Well, what if it was?
But it isn't.
Career's winding down. There's one team offering him a deal.
But we're not at that point. So that I'm telling you that's a hypothetical question you're asking me. But I'm just telling you factually we're not at that point.
Okay, so who else offered him a contract?
I'm not telling you.
Okay. Well, you led us right into that, for crying out loud.
No, I mean, I personally, did
the Rangers offer him a contract?
Just not going to the Flyers. That's just not a part of the equation.
Would you rather him play for the Flyers, where your daughter and your granddaughter are still relatively close?
He can play for the Wasps.
Or sign in Edmonton?
Edmonton.
Oh, God.
Wow.
He can play with Connor McDavid.
Wow.
You know, and he can go
that's
out there.
That's unbelievable. Right. I mean, you could see your granddaughter, like, on a weekly basis if he's in Philadelphia. In Edmonton, you're never going to see her.
Might as well be in Russia.
See, here's the thing. You don't understand. If he signs with Philadelphia, my granddaughter will be scarred for life. And that's just, I cannot allow that to happen.
So both the Rangers and Islanders offered him a contract?
I didn't say that. No. I didn't say that. And I'm not saying, all I'm saying is that I just told him, I don't care. I don't care if Alain Vigneault calls you. I don't even know who the freaking owner is. If they call you, you don't even answer the phone.